All right, we go now to Latvia, which has been providing a lot of support to Ukraine. It also has a sizable Russian-speaking minority, a legacy of the time when Latvia was part of the Soviet Union. Now, they have been a target of the Kremlin's propaganda machine in a bid to undermine support for Ukraine. Our reporter, Killian Bayer, visited a town close to the Russian border to see what impact Kremlin propaganda is having.
Latvia, along the Russian border, many people here watch Russian state television via satellite and over the internet. And with that, propaganda from Russia.
Dear friends, drown the children, drown them. There will be nuclear war.
Threats of war broadcast across the border from Latvia's much bigger neighbor, Russia. This worries Maria Dubitska. One in four Latvians has Russian heritage and speaks Russian. Since the Ukraine war started, Latvia has become even more polarized.
We're losing our friends and our neighbors. That hurts. Propaganda is like poison that's dividing the people.
The 66-year-old and her son Yanis have lots of Russian friends. Russian TV is blocked here, but many people still manage to watch a lot of it. Even before the Russian invasion, the information war was well underway. Russian media frequently broadcasts aggressive rhetoric about the EU and NATO. In a talk show on Russian TV, a military expert described step by step how Russia hypothetically could invade the Baltic states.
The Kaliningrad grouping of the Russian army and Belarusian forces cut them off from the rest of NATO. While soldiers from the Western Military District advance into Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. A new government for each country, the National People's Republic of Estonia, the National People's Republic of Latvia, and Lithuania.
Many people in the eastern part of Latvia look back fondly on their Soviet past, especially here along one of the main roads connecting Riga to Moscow, where some people feel left behind by democratic developments.
We're right in the center of Rizikne, a small town not far from the Russian border, about half an hour drive, and around half of the population, a bit less, is Russian-speaking. We've come here to find out how many people here actually watch Russian television.
Are you happy with Russian media? Very happy. And the quality? I have to leave.
These days it's better not to answer questions like this. As a Russian, you're scared of voicing your opinion. They're foaming at the mouth with hatred.
I watch Latvian TV.
There's propaganda on both sides.
32 years ago, this was all part of the Soviet Union. Many people came here from other parts of the giant Soviet empire to work, and then stayed to this day. Maria insists that not everyone feels the same here, and she says that anyone can be poisoned by television regardless of their nationality. She has given up discussing politics with many of her neighbors.
We want to live in freedom on Earth. We do not want to be ruled by anyone. Here, we have the right to live in self-determination. That's very important.
Maria Dubitska is proud that Latvia now belongs to the EU and not to the Soviet Union, as was once the case. Out here in the countryside, she enjoys her free time just a short drive from the Russian border.